Everybody, we will start the session. As it has already been said, it carries 40 marks, and if you can get 10 or 15 marks extra in the ward rounds, since the DNB exam, separate pass is not necessary. If you are deficient by 10 marks in the clinical, you can compensate it in your ward rounds. So one area where in the ward there may be different types of tractions. So one area where the examiners are very much interested is to take the candidates to the place where there is a traction. It can be a skin traction, can be a skeletal traction. A skeletal traction can be an upper tibial, a lower tibial, lower femoral, trochanteric traction, which is extremely rare nowadays. The calcaneal tractions, the pelvic tractions, the skull traction, and the halter traction. Any one of these may be there in most of the orthopedic wards, so you'll be taken there. So the first stop usually will be this bed where a patient has been given traction. So the examiner will ask you name the assembly. So it is an upper tibial traction on a ball or bone splint. The next question is, what is this ball or bone splint? Who described the splint first, ball or bone? It is Bowler's modification of the bone splint. Then the common indication for using it nowadays, it is usually used as a temporary measure in cases of fracture shaft of femur. And rarely it can be used in the management of upper femoral and acetabular fractures. Then how many pulleys are there? As you see here, there are four pulleys. Then what are the uses of these pulleys? So the lower one, this lower one is for giving calcaneal and lower tibial traction. The second pulley here is for giving upper tibial traction. This one is for lower femoral traction, and this is for preventing foot drop. The next question will be, how will you prevent foot drop? That is by attaching an adhesive tape onto the sole of the foot and attach a very small weight over the first pulley in the reverse direction. This will give a dorsiflexion pull and prevent equinus in these patients. In some of the wards, our residents may put traction in this manner. There may be one there. The examiner will take you there and ask what is wrong here. Here, it is the wrong pulley that is used. Ideally, it has to go through this upper pulley, but it is going through the first pulley. That is the wrong. Then what type of a traction is this? Is it a fixed traction or a sliding traction? So the answer is it is a sliding traction, because there is weight here and the foot end of the bed is elevated so that the body weight is pulling it in the reverse direction. So the reason for elevating the foot end of the bed is to make it into a sliding traction. So how much elevation is necessary? It is said to be 2.5 centimeters for every LB traction weight. That is what is given in the book on traction, that is Stewart. How much weight is added? It is about 10% of the body weight. Around 8 kg weight can be added. Usually around 6 to 8 kg is what is added there. Then what is wrong in this traction? So what is pointed here is the knee joint. So this comes to the landmark of putting the Steenman pin. So your tibial tuberosity will be here. It is usually done half an inch below and lateral. So it should be at a much higher level. So it is given at a very low level. How will you apply the pin? Then the student will have to give in detail the procedure of putting the pin. The first sterile precautions he will have to explain. Then the identification of the landmark where he wants to put the pin. Then give adequate local anesthesia. He should not forget the anesthetizing the periosteum because it is very painful. Then the incision which is used, the examiner will ask you whether you need a horizontal incision or a transverse incision or a cruciate incision. Various research show that the cruciate incision appears to be better and has got less incidence of pin track infection. Then, how will you introduce the pin? Will you hammer it, or you have got power drill? Will you use the power drill, or you have got the hand drill? Which one will you use? Usually, it is introduced through a hand drill, not through a power drill, because heat necrosis can occur around the pins. It should never be hammered because the opposite cortex will get splintered. What is the type of pin that is used? Know that two types of pins are there. One is the Steenman pin and the other is a Denham pin. The Steenman pin is a smooth pin with a trocar tip. That is the common one that is used. But for elderly with osteoporosis, the Denham pin, which has got thread in the middle, as you see here, this is the Denham pin with the thread in the middle, can be used because it gives more stability. Then, how will you attach it to the traction? It is attached by using this, which is called as a bowler stirrup. The bowler stirrup, and this area is for attaching the tape, for the traction tape. And here you can see something with a nut here, and this is for attaching the pin. So this bowler stirrup will fix the Steenman pin to the skeletal traction unit. The second thing is it helps in attaching weight to the traction unit. So this part is for attaching weight, and this part is for attaching the Steenman pin. And there are nuts here. You have to tighten the nut, otherwise the Steenman pin will bowler stirrup will slide over the Steenman. The third thing is that it can freely rotate. This small structure here, what you see here, can easily rotate. So it can give correct direction for the traction forces. Then the examiner go to the next step and will ask you who was the bowler. Full name was Lorenz Bowler. He is from Austria and he worked in University of Vienna. Then he will ask you what are the other contributions of bowler apart from the bowler's stirrup. So he has described or modified the bronze splint, and second, the bowler's ankle, which we are all know in the calcaneal, and it is very useful in calcaneal fractures. And one of the earliest textbooks of fractures, which was published in 1929, was by Bowler. In some of the hospitals, they may have this assembly. This is called as a Chanley's traction unit. Chanley's traction unit, you incorporate the Steenman pin in a Belloni plaster cast. It has got several advantages. One, it prevents the equinus by keeping the foot in neutral position. The pressure sore or the heel can be avoided. The rotation of the foot of the distal fragment and the distal fragment can be avoided. So the foot will not, the fracture will not move in that area, and less chance of lateral popliteal nerve palsy, and ipsilateral tibial fracture can be treated conservatively. But nowadays, most of these floating knee injuries are treated surgically, so that is not an indication. But if you have decided treat it for a few days conservatively before the patient becomes fit for surgery, then you can use this Chanley's traction unit. So, as a resident, when you go to the ward, what are the things that you are going to monitor? You have to monitor the 5 P's. The first is pulse has to be monitored. Any ischemic signs should be looked into. Ask whether there is any paresthesia. Always look for pressure sores. The pin tract is very important. You need to clean the pin tract every day with saline. You can use an antiseptic solution like betadine or spirit. And it is much better to leave it open rather than covering it. Then daily physiotherapy, cordyceps exercises has to be given. And in olden days, we used to use portable x-rays to finding out the alignment, because in olden days, many of the fracture shaft of females were treated conservatively by using a bowler bone frame followed by either a spica or a cast brace.